Wildcat at Frontier City in Oklahoma City is a wooden roller coaster that always intrigued me. Between the lack of enthusiasts visiting Frontier City and the fact the ride is tucked away in the woods, reviews and footage of this coaster are far and few between. So it was a bit of a mystery to me how it would ride. Wildcat originally opened in 1967 at Fairyland Park in Kansas City. Built by the National Amusement Device Company, or NAD for short, Wildcat closed with the park in 1977. The ride sat idle for almost a decade until Frontier City purchased the ride in 1990. But the ride was modified extensively before being relocated and reopened as Wildcat in 1991 at Frontier City. I've never seen a photo of the ride at Fairyland Park, but most of the changes occurred on the return run from what I've gathered. But in general, modifications really are the story with Wildcat. Beyond the initial modifications to make Wildcat work on the plot of land at Frontier City, this coaster has seen several changes over the years. Until 1999, Wildcat operated with NAD trains. Those trains seated a maximum of 16 riders per cycle across 4 2-bench cars. And each row had a shared lap bar between riders, much like the lap bars you'll find on Morgan Wood coaster trains. From the 1999 season onward, Wildcat has run 3-car, 3-bench Philadelphia Toboggan Company trains. On the plus side, this did increase the max riders per train from 16 to 18, but the single shared lap bar was replaced by individual ratcheting lap bars. And then sometime in the early 2000s, Wildcat lost its second train, and it has run with one ever since, which makes it the worst coaster in the park from a capacity standpoint. But the more impactful changes are all the additional reprofiling this coaster has received. I don't have a timeline when all these changes happened, but I suspect they occurred around the time the trains were replaced in 1999. The first drop and subsequent two camelbacks were made considerably more shallow. From the old POVs, these drops look quite steep and ripe with airtime if you sat towards the back. And the third hill actually used to be this odd-looking double up. The hill began with this tiny bunny hill before ascending the rest of the camelback. And I imagine that little bunny hill gave some amazing airtime with how fast you would have traveled over it. Now, that bunny hill is gone, and instead, you have this gradual upward slope leading into the third hill. It looks really awkward. The bunny hill after the turnaround used to take place in a tunnel. But now, that hill is completely out in the open. And to add insult to injury, you can still see the raised supports alongside the track that were previously used for the tunnel. This bunny hill also used to drop further down, so it would then have to rise up into a little airtime hill before navigating a really tight left-hand turn. Now, Wildcat levels off before the turnaround, and it takes that turn far more gradually. But arguably, the worst modification is the finale. Wildcat used to fly over the final hill and fly down a double down, which supposedly gave some awesome airtime. And then it traveled past the splashdown pool that used to fire synchronized geysers as the train whizzed by. But now, Wildcat brings riders to an abrupt, full, and complete stop before the old double down. Worse, the double down has been reprofiled into a single shallow drop. This results in an extremely awkward finale. Again, I never rode Wildcat before all these changes happened, but from the video footage I could find and the few reviews that exist, the current version seems significantly tamer than how it ran when it was originally opened at Frontier City. And it really is a shame, because Wildcat has a great setting in the woods and Frontier City really needs a signature custom coaster. For the Wildcat you can experience today, I strongly recommend sitting in the front row. If you sit up front, you'll actually get some airtime. If you sit further back in the train, you will get absolutely no airtime. And the coaster becomes a bit bumpier as well, for the double whammy. Up front, Wildcat was pretty darn smooth, presumably because the ride was retracked back in 2016. Wildcat begins with a 75-foot-tall lift that gives a bird's-eye view of the park's tiny water park. You then turn to the right and descend down a shallow 65-foot drop, reaching the ride's max speed of 46 miles per hour. The second hill has what I would call bouncy airtime, if you're up front. Bouncy airtime is that sensation you get on an older wooden coaster when the airtime sort of blends together with the roughness to give you multiple small pops of airtime in rapid-fire succession on one hill. The third hill gives more traditional airtime. It's just a really weak pop of airtime if you're up front. The fourth hill is much smaller, so it gives another dose of bouncy airtime. That's followed by the far turnaround, and I have to be honest, I thought this turn was going to kill me when I saw how awkwardly it was profiled. You start to bank before you even finish the fourth drop, and then it abruptly wraps around a tree. I braced for the worst, but it really wasn't that bad. It wasn't too bumpy unless you were in a wheel seat, and it offered some laterals. The bunny hill after this turnaround gives another weak bit of airtime if you're up front, but then the ride dies. You round that reprofiled flat turn, line yourself up with the finale, travel down another shallow drop, and then slam into the brake run. I was not prepared for how violently that brake run would stop the train. It felt like when you stop short in a car, except in a car, the seatbelt catches you. On Wildcat, the lap bar is jammed into your stomach when you come to that stop. You then crawl into the drained splashdown pool and pop back into the station, ending the ride very anticlimactically. So what would I rate Wildcat? I'd give this coaster a 5 out of 10. Most of my contempt towards this ride is the fact that I know it used to be so much better. I couldn't help but think of all the airtime this coaster used to provide in its glory days. But when I look at Wildcat in a vacuum for what it is today, it's a decent wood coaster up front. It's reasonably smooth up front and has a few tiny pops of airtime, plus that wonderful wooded setting. Towards the back, Wildcat's not unbearable by any means. Rather, it's just boring since you get no airtime in the back rows. So those are my thoughts on Wildcat, the lone custom roller coaster of Frontier City. What are your thoughts on this ride? I'm especially interested to hear from anyone who rode it in the early to mid-1990s before it was modified to its current form. I would love to hear comments down below. If you enjoyed this review, I'd appreciate if you gave this video a like and consider subscribing because there'll be a lot more amusement park and roller coaster videos here at Canby Coaster. Thanks for listening.